नियतिकृतनियमरहितां ख्यादैकमयीम् अनन्यपरतन्त्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिम् आदधति भारती कवेर्जयति. तु लुकिङ्ग् एट् अविमृष्टविधेयांशः एण्ड् इन् देट् द लास्ट् लेट् मी गिव् अ काण्टेक्स्ट् एण्ड् देन् वील् डू देट् लास्ट् श्लोक अगेन्. ऐ डोण्ट् थिङ्क् वि डिड् देट् प्रापर्ली. यत् शब्दः तु उत्तरवाक्य अनुगतत्वेन उपात्तः सामर्थ्यात् पूर्वववाक्य अनुगतस्य तच्छब्दस्य उपादानं न अपेक्षते यथा. सो द अवान्तरसङ्गति दट् हि गिव्स् फार् द श्लोकं साधु चन्द्रमसि पुष्करैः कृतं. सो द काण्टेक्स्ट् हियर् इस् वेदर् यत् शब्द एण्ड् वेर् इन् प्लेसस् वेर् दि यत् शब्द एण्ड् तत् शब्द आर् यूस्ड् वेदर् युर् there is a dosha or not, avimrushta vidheyamsha dosha exists or not, because yat shabda, the expression that we give with yat shabda is uddeshyam, that which we know before. Vidheya is the ajnatamsha which we use with the tat shabda. Now both have to be present or not is the question here. It is not necessary that each one should be present. For that he gave the Vidheya Anupasthitihi, he gave the example of Apanga Samsargi is the dosham, it is a dosha yuktam shlokam. After that, where it is not a dosha yuktam, he said Prakranta Prasiddha Anubhutartha Vishayaha Tachabdaha Yachabda Upadhanam Napekshate. If there is only the Tachabda mentioned and Yat is not mentioned, if the if it is a Prakranta, that is it, if it is contextual, or if it is Prasiddham, Loka Prasiddham, or if it is anubhutartha, then yachabdaha tachabdam vinaiva tachabdaha yachabdam vinaiva upayoktam shaknumaha. Right, for that we saw three examples. And now yachabdaha tu, if that yat shabda is used in the uttaravakya, uttaravakya gatatvena upattaha chet सामर्थ्यात् पूर्ववाक्य अनुगतस्य तच्छब्दस्य उपादानं न अपेक्षते. सो हौ इस् द दोषस्थलं डिटर्मिन्ड्? यत् दि एक्स्प्रेशन् आफ् यत् यः गच्छति सः अध्यापकः. इफ् देट् इस् द केस् एण्ड् इफ् ऐ से अध्यापकः यः गच्छति, इफ् ऐ यूस् द यत् शब्द इन् दि उत्तरवाक्यं, यत् शब्दः तु उत्तरवाक्य अनुगतत्वेन उपात्तः. इफ् इट् इस् अ पार्ट् आफ् द फालोयिङ्ग् सेण्टेन्स् दट् फालोस्, द फस्ट् पार्ट् इस् तत् शब्द एण्ड् द सेकेण्ड् पार्ट् इस् यत् शब्द, देन् पूर्ववाक्य अनुगतस्य तत् शब्दस्य. इन् द फस्ट् फार्मर् सेण्टेन्स् वी नीड् टु हाव् द तत् शब्द. ईवन् इफ् वी डु नाट् हाव् द तत् शब्द, इट् इस् ओके, इट् इस् नाट् ए दोषस्थलम्. For that, he gives this example, Sadhu Chandramasi Pushkaraihi Kritam Meelitam Yada Abhiramata Adhike Udyata Jayini Kamini Mukhe Tena Sahasam Anushthitam Punaha. Pragupattastu Yachabdaha Tachabda Upadanam Vina Sakankshaha. Now, this section explains the dosha in the Apanga Samsargi Shlokam. So, let me just show you that maybe easier to look at it this way. Let it load. So in yattadoho nitya sambandha is your rule which we follow for yat and tat. In the dosha sthalam we saw apanga samsargi tarangitam bhuvoho, the last line which is relevant here, where the yat shabda connects with everything else, which is tanoho tanoti yo asau subhage tava agataha. Here the yachabda bhagam is yaha asau tava tanoho romancha prasari romanchanam prasari tanoti. The tachabdamshaha is actually saha agataha or soyam agataha, that is your apekshitaha tachabdaha. So you should either give it as soyam agataha. In some way or the other, that should have been present. Because the yachabda bhagam is prag upattaha. It has been mentioned in the beginning. तच्छब्दम् इफ् इट् इस् मेन्शन् इफ् द यच्छब्द पोर्शन् इस् प्रेसेण्ट् बिफोर् एण्ड् द तच्छब्द पोर्शन् इस् प्रेसेण्ट् आफ्टर् वर्ड्स् इट् एक्स्पेक्ट्स् दट् तच्छब्दः सोऽयम् अथवा सः समथिङ्ग् आर् दि अदर् शुड् हेव् बीन् प्रेसेण्ट् इन् दट् श्लोक दट् शब्दम् इस् नाट् प्रेसेण्ट् हेन्स् इट् इस् अ दोष ऐ विल् एक्स्प्लेन् दिस् this asauna tatshabdartha I will explain it later now in this present context where he is using that sadhu chandramasi pushkaraihi kritam meelitam here how does he explain this the yatshabdamsham is only yat abhiramata adhike chandramasi abhiramata adhike chandramasi sati when the chandra when the moon which is very beautiful abhiramata adhike which possesses an extreme beauty is present pushkaraihi meelitam yat yat pushkaraihi meelitam the fact that the lotuses have closed themselves or they are not blooming that sadhu kritam comes as a purva vakyam and the yat shabdam yat shabdamshah comes as an uttara vakyam so yat shabdasto atra uttara vakya gatatvena upattah tasmat tat shabdam na apekshate even if that tat shabda is not present we don't have tat sadhu kritam that tat shabdamshah is not present here even if it is not present there is no dosham because that tat shabdamshah tu purvam upattah tat shabdah और तच्छब्द अंशः पूर्वम् उपात्तः यच्छब्दस्तु उत्तरवाक्यगतत्वेन उपात्तः दैट इज योर की हियर टु एक्सप्लेन वेदर इट इज अ दोषस्थलम और अदोषस्थलम वेर इट दिस श्लोक कुड हैव हैड अ दोष इफ इट हैड बीन रीकंस्ट्रक्टेड द फर्स्ट लाइन इफ इट वाज रीकंस्ट्रक्टेड इन द फॉलोइंग मैनर मीलितम यद अभिरामताधिके साधु मीलितं यद् अभिरामताधिके साधु चन्द्रमसि पुष्करैः कृतम् नौ हियर् वाट् वुड् हव् हेपेण्ड् इस् यत् मीलितम् इस् द यच्छब्दांश एण्ड् देन् पुष्करैः यत् कृतं साधु दट् इस् द तच्छब्दांश विच् हस् कम् बिहैण्ड् देन् वी विल् नीड् द तत् साधु कृतम् सो इफ् द फस्ट् लैन् हेड् बीन् रीकन्स्ट्रक्टेड् इन् दिस् मेनर् देन् इट् इस् अ दोष because he has taken this sadhu the tatshabdamsha in the beginning before the yatshabdamsha it is not a dosha that is your key point here okay now oh this is the next one wait one minute now let's look at the text what he says so prag upattah yatshabdah तच्छब्द उपादानं विना इफ् दि यच्छब्दांश इस् इन् द बिगिनिङ्ग् देन् द तच्छब्द उपादानं विना विदौट् टेकिङ्ग् द तच्छब्द साकाङ्क्षः इट् रिमेन्स् वित् एन् एक्स्पेक्टेन्सि साकाङ्क्षः आकाङ्क्षा तत्र वर्तते एव तच्छब्दस्य आकाङ्क्षा वर्तते विच् इस् द इन् दि अपाङ्गसंसर्गी दट् श्लोक विसो यथा अत्रैव श्लोके आद्यपदयोः व्यत्यासे दिस् आद्यपदयोः व्यत्यासे इस् वाट् ऐ शुड् सो आद्यपदयोः व्यत्यासे इस् योर् दिस् वन् मीलितं यद् अभिरामताधिके इट् हेस् बीन् ट्रान्स्पोस्ड् इफ् इट् इस् ट्रान्स्पोस्ड् सो यथा अत्रैव श्लोके आद्यपदयोः व्यत्यासे वेन् द होल् थिङ्ग् इस् ट्रान्स्पोस्ड् देन् देर् इस् अ साकाङ्क्षः नौ द्वयोः उपादाने नौ दिस् स्टार्ट्स् द नेक्स्ट् सेक्षन् वेर् यु हेव् बोत् दि यत् शब्द एण्ड् द तत् शब्द प्रेसेण्ट् देन् देर् इस् नो इश्यू द्वयोः उपादाने तु निराकाङ्क्षत्वं प्रसिद्धम् इट्स् वेरि फेमस् दट् इफ् वि हेव् यः गच्छति सः अध्यापकः इफ् ऐ जस्ट् से यः गच्छति अध्यापकः इट् एक्स्पेक्ट्स् समथिङ्ग् एल्स् सः किं करोति इति वयं प्रश्नं पृच्छामः रैट् सो बिकास् यु आर् जस्ट् नाट् यूसिङ्ग् तत् शब्द देर् इफ् ऐ से अध्यापकः यः गच्छति देन् इट् डजन्ट् एक्स्पेक्ट् अ तत् शब्द बिकास् दट् तत् शब्दांश इस् पुट् इन् फ्रण्ट् विल् मीन्स् सः अध्यापकः यः गच्छति, यः तत्र तिष्ठति, अग्रे तिष्ठति. सो देट् इस् अ सिम्प्लर् वर्जन् आफ् हौ टु अण्डर्स्टाण्ड् दिस् रिलेशन् बिट्वीन् दि यत् एण्ड् द तत्. Now, dvayoho upadane tu nirakankshatvam prasiddham. When both the yat and the tat are mentioned, then there is dvayoho upadane. When both are present, you don't need a third one for there. There is no necessity for another yat or another tat there. Anupadane api samarthyat kutrachit dvayam api gamyate. This is very important, but this is later. So anupadane api, even if the yat and the tat are not given, samarthyat, by the force of the words that the kapoet uses in such a creative manner, gamyate, dvayam api gamyate, both can be understood, both the yat shabda and the tat shabda can be understood in certain cases, kutrachit, in some cases, dvayam api yat shabda, yat padam, तत्पदम् इति द्वयमपि गम्यते. यथा नौ द एग्जाम्पल् हि गिव्स् वेर् बोत् आर् गिवन् इस् येनाम केचित् इह नः प्रथयन्ति अवज्ञां, जानन्ति ते किमपि तान् प्रति नैष यत्नः. उत्पत्स्यते अस्ति मम कोऽपि समानधर्म, कालोह्ययं निरवधिः विपुला च पृथ्वी. दिस् इस् भावभूतिः श्लोक. He says this in Malati Madhava, in the first act. That Malati Madhavam is a prakaranam, a 10-act play, which is Vibhatsarasam. So generally, natakam or prakaranam have to have either Shringara or Veerarasa as the pradhanam. So Bhavabhuti was a different person who was not supposed to be. He was an anachronic, what do you call that? He was not supposed to have been in that century is what I feel. He made a lot of new things which did not fit into that. So a lot of people criticized him. In order to counter those criticisms, he said, Ye nama kechit iha naha avagnyam prathayanti. Ye nama, those who all pratayanti avagnyam, they show a contempt towards my work, iha in my work or in this world, naha, those who are all showing contempt towards me. Naha is a royal we. So naha avagnyam yenama kechit pratayanti jananti te kimapi, they probably know a lot of things. I am not disputing their intelligence at all. Jananti te kimapi, they know something. Tan prati naisha yatnaha. This effort is not towards a person who is showing contempt towards me. He's got so much of confidence in his work that he says, Tan prati naisha yatnaha. I am not writing this work for them. So then, whom are you writing this work? It cannot just remain in some godown, right? So he says, Utpatsyate. Maybe there will come a person who appreciates my work. Utpatsyate. Asti, athava asti, adhuna eva, asmin kale eva, asti, probably, I don't know. So asti, mama kopi samana dharma, mama samana dharma kopi utpatsyate athava asti. So how are you so sure that there will be someone who will be born, who shares your opinion in this, with a similar quality? Or how can you say with so much of confidence that the person exists even now? See, two things he gives the hetu. Kalohyayam niravadihi, the time is limitless. I don't know when a person might come, he might unearth this and say, this is the best work that I have seen, and it transcends time. He's so confident that his work transcends time. Even today we can appreciate the beauty of his work. Right? So utpatsyate, what is the reason for that? Kalohyayam niravadihi, this kala, this time is niravadihi. And then vipula cha prithivi. Asti, how can you be so sure that there is someone who is present? It means vipula cha prithivi. I don't know in which corner of the world a person might come who appreciates this. No, we think that it is only appreciated in India, Sanskritam is appreciated in India, or maybe in Europe because of the English and everything. I found very recently, I found one Korean scholar who has written Vyakhyana for Amarushatakam and a couple of other works also. I mean, you really don't know where, in which corner of the world a person might exist who appreciates what is there. So even he's not a recent scholar. He's quite a maybe an 18th century or even 17th century. So you don't know. Kalohyam niravadihi vipulacha prithivi. Someone might come at some point. Utpatsyate. This will become one Bhavoti class now. Yenava kechidihanaf prathayantyavagnyam jananti te kimapi. Now that is your yat and tat shabda correlation here. Yat tadoho nitya sambandha. So ye avagnyam prathayanti तान् प्रति न यत्नः अथवा ते किमपि जानन्ति ये अवज्ञां प्रथयन्ति ते किमपि जानन्ति अथवा तान् प्रति नैष यत्नः बोथ् आर् कनेक्टेड् हियर् सो वेन् यत् शब्द इस् प्रेसेण्ट् एण्ड् तत् शब्द इस् प्रेसेण्ट् वी डोण्ट् एक्स्पेक्ट् नौ हियर् देर् इस् यू वन् केन् आर्ग्यू देट् देर् इस् ओन्ली वन् यत् शब्द वेर् एस् देर् आर् टु तत् शब्दस् सो ये अवज्ञां प्रथयन्ति इस् वन् यत् शब्द एण्ड् देन् ते किमपि जानन्ति तान् प्रति नैष यत्नः सो इफ् यु लुक् इट् इट् देर् इस् ओन्ली वन् यत् शब्द वेर् एस् देर् आर् टु तत् शब्दस् सो हौ विल् इट् कनेक्ट् देन् दिस् तान् आल्सो एक्स्पेक्ट्स् अनदर् थिङ्ग् नो वन् इट् सेल्फ् सेटिस्फैड् सेटिस्फैस् बोत् तत् शब्दस् हियर् सो ये अवज्ञां प्रथयन्ति ते जानन्ति ये अवज्ञां प्रथयन्ति तान् प्रति न यत्नः सो इट् सेटिस्फैस् देट् इस् इनफ् So that's why he says in the line before this, Dvayoho upadane tu nirakankshatvam prasiddham. Anupadane api samarthyat kutrachit dvayamapi gamyate. Here, even here, one yat shabda is only present, whereas you have two tat shabda, samarthyat avagamyate. At the same time, the second line also, if you look at it, yaha utpatsyate तं प्रति यत्नः यः उत्पत्स्यते तं प्रति यत्नः यः अस्ति मम समानधर्मा यः अस्ति मम समानधर्मा यः उत्पत्स्यते तं प्रति यत्नः क्रियते इति अवगम्यते दट् इस् द सामर्थ्यात् अवगम्यते सो दिस् श्लोक इस् एक्चुअली एन् एक्साम्पल् फार् बोत् वेर् द्वयोरुपादाने निराकाङ्क्षत्वम् इफ् बोत् आर् प्रेसेण्ट् देन् देर् इस् नो आकांक्षा फॉर यत् शब्द और तत् शब्द विच इज वेरी पॉपुलर एंड दैट इज इट नीड्स नो एक्सप्लेनेशन द्वयोर अनुपादाने क्वचित् अवगम्यते वी अंडरस्टैंड इट फॉर एग्जांपल इन द सेकंड लाइन ऑफ द श्लोक इटसेल्फ उत्पत्स्यते अस्ति मम कोऽपि समान धर्म दैट इज एक्चुअली इन कनेक्शन विद तान् प्रति नैष यत्नः यू हैव टू टेक इट एज उत्पत्स्यते यः उत्पत्स्यते तं प्रति यत्नः यः अस्ति तं प्रति यत्नः सो दट् यत् शब्द एण्ड् तत् शब्द इस् अण्डर्स्टुड् गम्यते ओके आफ्कोर्स् कालोह्ययं निरवधिः विपुला च पृथिवी इस् अर्थान्तर्न्यास देर् विच् इस् आल्सो जस्टिफिकेशन् आफ् वाट् ही हेस् सेड् बिफोर् सच् अ प्रौड् पर्सन् ऐ डोण्ट् केर् इफ् देर् आर् क्रिटिसिसम्स् फोर् मी ये नाम केचित् इहनः प्रथयन्त्यवज्ञां जानन्ति ते किमपि तान् प्रति नैष यत्नः उत्पत्स्यते अस्ति मम कोऽपि समानधर्मा कालोह्ययं निरवधिः विपुला च पृथ्वी नौ एवम् इन् कन्क्लूशन् एवं तच्छब्द अनुपादाने अत्र साकाङ्क्षत्वं नौ हियर् एवं दस् बै प्रूविङ्ग् आल् आफ् दीस् थिङ्ग्स् हि हेस् सेड् दट् तच्छब्द अनुपादाने इफ् तच्छब्द इस् नाट् यूस्ड् अत्र साकाङ्क्षत्वम् अत्र इस् योर् अपाङ्गसंसर्गि इन् दिस् श्लोक ओके हियर् तच्छब्द अनुपादानात् दोषः दट् इस् योर् कन्क्लूशन् हियर् सो अत्र यु हेव् टु टेक् द श्लोक अपाङ्गसंसर्गि इति श्लोके तच्छब्द अनुपादाने साकाङ्क्षत्वम् तच्छब्दस्य आकाङ्क्षा वर्तते इति कारणात् अपाङ्गसंसर्गि इति श्लोके अभिमृष्टविधेयांशदोषः वर्तते नौ अ क्वश्चिन् केन् अरैस् लेट्स् गो बेक् टु दट् श्लोक वेर् हि सेस् यो असौ आगतः वै डोण्ट् ऐ टेक् इट् एस् यः तनोः रोमाञ्चनं तनोति असौ आगतः. देन् द तत्शब्द आकाङ्क्षा पूर्ति हेस् हेपेण्ड् रैट्. वि डोण्ट् असौ केन् आक्ट् एस् ए तत्शब्द. देट् इस् युर् नेक्स्ट् क्वश्चन् देट् हि रैसेस् इन् द टेक्स्ट्. सो न च असौ इति तत्शब्दार्थम् आह. असौ शब्द केनाट् बि ट्रीटेड् एस् तत्शब्द. For that he gives an example. This example actually shows where asau is not a tat shabda. Asau can only mean as eshaha, I am, and all that in this context. Then the next shloka he is going to say how, when the manner in which asau shabda is used, it can indicate a tat shabda, but in this particular shloka it is not. Now first let's look at how asau shabda cannot be a tat shabdartha. Atra hi na tat shabdartha pratitihi. In this shloka, let's look at that shloka now. It's a slesha. So as always, I like to put a tabular column so it is easy for me also to explain and for people also to understand. So asau marut chumbita charu kesaraha prasannataradhipa mandalagranihi वियुक्त रामातुर दृष्टि वीक्षितः वसन्तकालो हनुमान् इव आगतः. हनुमान् नाटक, इट् इस् अ श्लोक फ्रम् हनुमान् नाटक, एण्ड् ईस् डिस्क्रैबिङ्ग् द स्प्रिङ्ग् सीसन्. इवन् टु डिस्क्रैब् द स्प्रिङ्ग् सीसन् ही सेस् वसन्तकालः हनुमान् इव आगतः. वसन्तकालः, दिस् स्प्रिङ्ग् सीसन् हेस् कम् एण्ड् द वे इट् इस् एण्टर्ड् इस् लैक् आञ्जनेय. हौ इस् दट्? सो ही गिव्स् त्री एड्जेक्टिव्स् फार् both the vasanta kala and hanuman. Marut chumbita charu kesaraha. Marut pavanaha, pavanena maruta chumbitaha kesaraha. So it's called tamil land uchi moharradu. When you during jatakarma namakaranam, jatakarma namakaranam, you first you are supposed to smell the top portion of the baby, right, on the forehead. So a father does that. So it's a very specific thing, and you are supposed to kiss the baby only here. That is marut chumbita kesaraha, on very close to where your forehead hair is. So he says maruta yasya kesaraha charu kesaraha sundaraha kesaraha romaha chumbitaha. So Hanuman's father kisses the baby where the hair is, the forehead hair. So tadrishaha hanuman. Now vasantakala pakshe tu marut pavanaha, wind. Chumbita is also meaning ishat sprishtam. So it slightly touches the bakula flowers which have bloomed during the spring season. So marut chumbita charu the kesaraha. So it is a spring season during which the bakula flowers, which are beautiful, have been lightly touched by the breeze. It's not a wind, it's a breeze. So marut chumbita charu kesaraha pavanena ishat sprishtaha bakulaha yasmin kale vartante tat tadrishaha kalaha. Next, prasanna taradhipa mandala agranihi. Prasannaha hanumat pakshe, prasannaha santushtaha sugrivaha tarayaha adipaha patihi sugrivaha tasya mandalam rajyam tasya mandale rajye rashtre agranihi agresaraha hanuman. He leads the entire army of Sugriva, and he is one of the pramukha in the Sugriva's rashtra. That is hanumat pakshe vasantakala. That is the prakritam, right? So how is the vasantakala? It is prasanna taradipa mandala agranihi. This it has a very clear chandra bimbam, where the chandra occupies the prime position during the spring season. See, during spring, because it is the season for Kamadeva Manmatha, the Chandra is an Uddipana Vibhava, and Vasantakalam has this Chandra as the Uddipana Vibhava. So he occupies a very important position during the Vasantaratu. So prasanna taradhipa mandala agranihi chandra bimbam agranihi vahati agrani padam vahati. Okay, that's fine. Next is viyukta ramatura drishti vikshitaha. Hanumat pakshe, it's very easy. Viyuktaha sitaya viyuktaha ramaha आतुरतया दट् इस् औत्सुक्येन हि लुक्स् एट् हनुमान् एस् इफ् हिस् एण्टैर् लैफ् डिपेण्ड्स् आन् हनुमान् हि लुक्स् एट् हिम् फार् गोयिङ्ग् एण्ड् फैण्डिङ्ग् सीता सो देट् हि केन् रीयुनैट् वित् सीता सो वियुक्त रामस्य आतुरदृष्ट्या वीक्षितः हनुमान् द सेपरेटेड् रामा लुक्स् एट् हिम् वित् अ ग्रेट् ईगर्नेस् बिकास् हि इस् गोयिङ्ग् टु बि दि इन्स्ट्रुमेण्ट् टु युनैट् वित् सीता वसन्तकालपक्षे तु वियुक्त रामा रामा इस् सुन्दरि द लेडीस् हू आर् सेपरेटेड् फ्रम् देयर् बिलवड् दे लुक् एट् दिस् सीज़न् दिस् स्प्रिङ्ग् सीज़न् वित् अ वेरि डिजेक्टेड् वे आर् दे आल्सो लुक् एट् इट् वित् अ वेरि ईगर् मेनर् दट् ड्यूरिङ्ग् द स्प्रिङ्ग् सीज़न् द नायक इस् गोयिङ्ग् टु फील् दट् लव् एण्ड् हि विल् वाण्ट् टु कम् एण्ड् जायिन् वित् द नायिका So Viyukta Ramaha, the Sundaryaha, they look at this spring season with an Atura. If they are separated, they don't want this Vasantakala at all because they will be reminded of their beloveds. So they will look at it with a Dukkha Drishtya Pashyanti Vasantaratu. That is Aturam. Aturam can be two things, either Dukkhita or Outsukhya. It can indicate both. So depending on that, the meaning goes. So here, now the prakritam is asau vasantakalaha hanuman iva agataha. Here, asau is actually yaha vasantakalaha maruchumbita charukesaraha prasannatara dipa mandalagranihi saha vasantakalaha hanuman iva agataha. So here that asau is cannot be used as saha vasantakalaha agataha. You cannot say that. It is not a tachabdartha pratitihi. So what he says here, so atrahi asmin shloke na tachabdartha pratitihi tukte asau shabdasya adash shabdasya asau iti padasya you don't tachabdartha pratitihi navartate because it is a pratyaksham. We are looking at the vasantakala as present at that point of time. So pratyaksha uktau asau iti shabdasya it is only indicating what we are seeing in front of us so there is no tat shabda pratiti tat will always happen with uddesham and videya so this shloka has nothing to do with abhimrishta videyamsha this shloka only explains us how the word asau cannot be taken as tat shabda so that's why It said here, asau na tachabdarthaha, which means here in this shloka, this yo asau cannot be tava agataha. Now, when can this asau act as a tachabda? That is your next shloka. One minute. So pratitau va, pratitau vityukte adashabdasya tachabda paryayatve ukte sati. Then, we can have it like this how is it karavala karala dosahayah yudhi yo asau vijayarjuna ekamallaha yadi bhupatina saha tatra karye viniyujyeta tataha kritam kritam syat here yaha yachabda vakyam is the first portion tachabda vakyam is actually used with asau so yaha asau bhupatihi so whoever this person I think it is karna who has been appointed by duryodhana in some work and this karna is equal to arjuna in pandava rajyam sorry in kaurava rajyam so karavala karala do sahayaha yaha asau actually one minute You don't need the tachabda. That's what he actually wants to say here. So, karavala, karala, dos sahayaha, yaha. Yaha, that person who, yudhi, in the battlefield, he has that sword as his sahaya, as his help. Karavala, karala, the bhayankara, karavala, bhayankaraha, karavalaha, karavala is khadga, karala is bhayankaraha, dosahayaha. His bahu is being helped by the khadga. So one whose arm one who has the sword for his help, one whose harm is being helped by the sword, by the terrible sword. So karavala karala dos sahayaha yudhi yaha vartate. Asau, that person is actually equal to Arjuna. Vijaya Arjuna Ekamallaha. He is the only person who can face Arjuna. Vijaya Arjuna, the victorious Arjuna, Ekamallaha means the only opponent. So the only opponent for Arjuna is this person who has the sword as a help for him. So Arjunena saha yodhum yaha ekaha eva shakyaha saha ayam khadgayuktaha karnaha. So that part is done. Yadi bhupatina saha tatra karye viniyujyeta. If Duryodhana appoints this Karna as a senapati, karye means senadhipatye. If yadi Duryodhanena bhupatina tatra karye senadhipatye viniyujyeta, if he appoints him, tataha, then kritam kritam syat, whatever that has to be done will be done. Will be the, in the sense that kritam kritam is also, each word is different. That kritam means what that has to be done. That is that Pandava forsook their kingdom, they left their kingdom and went away, and they will remain like that. That will be a, the second kritam means sapalam karyam. Whatever was started would be sapalam if he employs this person. Now here, yaha karavala dosahayaha asau vijayarjuna ekamallaha asti, full stop. Yadi bhupatina tatra karye viniyujyeta asau vijayarjuna ekamallaha yadi bhupatina karye viniyujyeta tataha kritam kritam syat. That is how the anvaya is, should happen. Then what happens here is that saha, the word atachabda, which is given, is actually irrelevant. It becomes a punaruktam. Tatra saha ityasya anarthakyam syat. Now, why it is not a problem in this shloka and why it is a problem in the earlier shloka? Because if you look at the way the words are arranged, karavala karala dosaha yaha yaha kama. Asau vijayarjuna ekamallaha bhupatina karye niyujyeta. That is where it is going and connecting. So the second half of the tachabdartha amsham is connected very beautifully in this manner. Whereas if you look at the other shloka, apanga samsargi, here tanos tanoti yaha asau subhage tava agataha. The problem here is asau is not directly connected with agataha. If we had had tanos tanoti yaha asau agataha, then there is no dosha. Do you understand the way it is? If there is a question, please ask. Because if the way it is arranged, this yachabda and tachabda is a very confusing topic. So we need to get it clearly. How it is arranged in the shloka and the way the pratiti or the way it is understood by the reader is very, very... sometimes it can be very twisted and confusing. So it's better to get it clear here. If that asau had been connected with the tatshabdamsha here also, and if the shloka had been as asau agataha, that tava should be in the yatshabdamsha, and none of the yatshabda expression should be after that asau. If that had been the case, then there is no problem. Just like in this shloka, here there is no dosham. So the yatshabdamsha is over with karavala karala dos sahaya yudhi yaha. That yatshabdamsha is over. Asau vijayarjuna mayekamallaha karye niyuktaha. That is where the tatshabdamsha happens without any portion of the yatshabdamsha coming in here and interfering with the flow of the thought. That saha, which is given in the second line, is actually redundant. It is not necessary, is a side thing that he says. Okay, so atra saha ityasya anarthakyam syat. Okay, we'll stop with this topic. The rest is actually, he goes further by saying how idam shabda can be used instead of tat shabda. In the same way, idam shabda can also, it also has to be used in an appropriate manner to convey that tat shabda pratiti. It cannot be used in a haphazard manner. You don't need to have only saha, sa, tat, only that should need not be there. Idam can also be used, adaha, that is asau amu ami can also be used. It's not an issue, but how the words are arranged and how your understanding happens because of the word arrangement in the shloka is very important. Okay, so we'll go slowly with this. For now, we have completed the others part. Now, next is idam that we will take up during the next class.